If you have a child and you want your child to become a generational hockey star, there really is only one way to go about it. Actually, two. First, you have to sign that kid up for junior hockey programs above his age range. And secondly, you have to name him Connor. Because when it comes to the generational hockey talents of 2023, Matvei Mishkov has had his fair share of the spotlight. We made a video earlier in the week talking about how he broke Nikita Kucherov's scoring record in the MHL for U17 players as a guy who was a week away from being a U16 guy. But the other guy, Connor Bedard, ooh boy, it's crazy that we've had to wait this long for Connor Bedard to come out here, but man oh man, Connor Bedard, the guy who was granted exceptional status for the WHL, the first player to ever be given that role 1 year ago, suited up for the Regina Pats yesterday and scored himself 2 goals. And as a 15-year-old in this hockey league, the first exceptional status player in the dub ever, scoring 1 goal, let alone 2, boy oh boy, we're absolutely seeing the best out of Connor here. And I say Connor because Connor McDavid had himself a night yesterday too, which I kind of wanted to talk about because, hey, we're talking about Connor Bedard, we're talking about generational Connors and exceptional status. Why not talk about McDavid as well? Because yesterday, the Regina Pats, before the actual game, posted a video of Connor McDavid congratulating Connor Bedard on the exceptional status, and later that night, Connor McDavid went out there and scored 3 points for the Oilers, reaching 51 points on the season. 50 points, the first player in the league to 50 this year in 29 games played, matching his season from last year, even though everybody says the North Division is the reason why McDavid and Draisaitl are getting so many points because it's so easy. But Connor McDavid was out here doing his thing, being the best player in the league yesterday against Ottawa. He's got like 11 points in his previous 4 games. No big deal for Connor McDavid after going pointless for 3 straight against Toronto. Yeah, this is him coming back with a vengeance. But for Connor Bedard, he suited up for the Regina Pats yesterday for the first time. And it's funny because it was literally a year ago. The video we made about Connor Bedard and his exceptional status was last year in March, and that was a video just praising the heck out of this guy, talking about how he is the next in line to the Crosbys and the McDavids. You could say the Shane Wrights, but honestly, I think Bedard is in his own kind of tier, just personally speaking, in my opinion. But for Connor Bedard, he came out here immediately for the Pats with a great first shift, because his first shift was out there where the Pats brought it into the offensive zone, and Bedard immediately, with those instincts that make him so deadly when he doesn't have the puck, waltzes his way over into the front of the net near the hash marks. He gets the pass from down low, cuts in, and he has a very good high danger scoring opportunity. That's great. He doesn't score on it right away, but he gets himself the opportunity. In fact, give it a little bit more, because in the second period, Connor Bedard, even though the Pats are down 3-0 at this point, he comes in on the power play, makes a move at the blue line around the Prince Albert Raiders defender, and waltzes his way to the front of the goal, where he shoots, he scores, he absolutely buries it, and that was a play that he did all by himself. That was Connor Bedard doing things that Connor Bedard is used to doing when he's playing against younger kids. He just comes in, walks around a guy, bloop, he shoots, he scores. Give it 40 seconds later, and Connor Bedard comes out here, lining up on the left side in the faceoff. The puck is won back, it's played out in front. Bedard picks it up in the faceoff circle. He comes into the front of the net. Hard forehand stride deep to make space. He shoots, he scores. Connor Bedard gets 2 goals in about a minute in his first WHL game. He ends the night with 7 shots on goal. 7. He's 15, dude. He's 15 years old, and he is out here already making the Regina Pats so much better than without this guy. The Pats lost 6-3, and Bedard had 2 of the goals there, so you can kind of see that he's already the top goal scorer on this team. He turned 16 in July. Sure, he's only listed as 5'10 on the Elite Prospects website, but he's 15, dude. He'll probably grow just a little bit, and if he doesn't, then I don't know, we'll just see how he goes from there, but I mean, his size has never really been that bad of a factor beforehand. You take a look at what he was able to do in the previous seasons of play with the West Van Academy Prep School. In the U15 rank, he had 88 points in 30 games played. That was in 2018-19, where he was only 13 years old. Yeah, pretty good. I'd imagine that a two-year gap in playing hockey when you're in your preteens is a lot bigger than a two-year gap when you're in your early 20s, because just the development standpoint, the amount of experience you have, not just in hockey, but in life in general, between 13 and 15, that's pretty big. And he was still out here getting 88 points in 30 games played as literally the top point guy in the entire league as a 13-year-old. Last year, he was only 14. He played for the U18 ranks at the West Van Academy Prep School. Guess what? 84 points, 36 games played, first in the league again. And this is U18 hockey. He's playing with 16, 17, some 18-year-olds. The guy's only 14. He's dominating. 43 goals, 41 assists, over 2 points a game, over a goal a game, over an assist a game. This season, he was loaned out to Sweden, where he played for HV71, the Region, and the Lachenelle team, and the point production followed him everywhere he went. Now he's in the WHL, playing with junior hockey Canadians, and he's at 2 goals in a game. Now, obviously, one game doesn't define a guy's entire career, but everything that we have seen from Connor Bedard up until this point is pointing towards a very special NHL talent, which is why I'm using that label, man. Generational, you know? I didn't want to bust it out for Alexis Lafreniere. I didn't want to say once that Owen Power Rachu was generational. I didn't want to say that it was generational for Savoy Wright or Lambert. I wanted to say it was close, but not really there yet, you know? But for Connor Bedard, I'm going to use that word. Because right now, as a 15-year-old guy, with the skating he has, with the elusiveness in his stride that he has, the ability to find space, the creativity, the shot especially, it's all pointing to a very special player. And the funny part is he might not even go first overall. Matvei Mishkov, you gotta remember, was labeled by the Olympics as the next best thing since Ovechkin. So this 1-2 for the 2023 draft is probably gonna be one of the best 1-2s that we have seen in a very long time. This is like up there with the Ovi Malkins in the mid-2000s. This is like McDavid Eichel right here. Now, Eichel's pretty good, but I think that just the way that both Mishkov and Bedard have been playing, there's a chance that these two could be better. Here's an article from Sportsnet. It's written by Sam Constantino back in April of 2020, talking about number 98. Connor Bedard, the guy who was granted exceptional status. This is a little scouting report, a little narrative-driven write-up about him, talking about how he's playing above his age group, how he's dominating all the competition that he plays against. It talks about how his training at the sports school for West Van Academy was conducted in such a way that forced Connor Bedard to make sure that he needed to live up to his potential every single day. One of the best parts about Connor Bedard's game is his shot. He's got an absolute lethal cannon that he just absolutely unleashes. It's like a howitzer right there, on the stick, off the stick in a hurry, and it's really deceptive. It doesn't look like he's going to shoot until he does. This is the write-up on Connor Bedard's shot, on how it actually got developed, because he's a right-handed shooter. He's got his left hand on top of the stick, his right hand around the middle-ish area. And 2 years ago, well, three, because this article was written a year ago, Bedard actually broke his right wrist. And over the 2 months he was out, he worked hard on his top hand, developing that strength. And as a result, when he had both wrists back, the absolute lethality of that wrist shot, ooh, boy, it's nasty. Just go out there and watch the clips, dude. Look at what this guy was able to do. But like all great NHL prospects and talents, it's not even just the shot that is the only good part of his game, it's everything else. This is another article on Sportsnet. This one's written by Mark Spector from March of 2020, so a little bit before that Constantino piece. Here's a quote from Steve Marr, the head coach of the West Van Academy. Talks about how Connor Bedard's shot is so good that one of the overlooked attributes of his game is his ability to pass the puck and find teammates through seams that most, if not all, players cannot. He's a playmaker too, boys. And, you know, I'm just really excited to see what he's going to be able to do, because Shane Wright, absolutely crazy resume for 2022. Same with Brad Lambert. Savoy getting off to a little bit of a slow start last year. We'll see how he rebounds. You got the guys in 2021 giving us a little bit of a different conversation because it's so wide open at the top. But for 2023, dude, it's Bedard, it's Mishkov, there's a few other guys in there as well, but, you know, when it comes to generational talents, I'm thinking 2023 is your guy. So, Mark your calendars, because Bedard, Mishkov, these guys are going to be great. But just from the Canadian Connor McDavid similarity story with Bedard, ooh, boy, this is exciting. So talk to me in the comments what you thought about this video over here. What do you think about Connor Bedard? What do you think his potential is going to be at the NHL level? I think first line center, just to throw a label out there, probably could hit 100 points if he develops in the way that we think he can. But who knows? The guy's only 15, so I don't want to say anything about that because that's huge pressure to put on a guy who is literally still in, like, ninth grade. So talk to me in the comments what you think. I hope you enjoyed this episode of Trolls99. And bye.